What up, y'all? It's your boy JB, aka Spoken, and I am here with another thing of unspoken truth. Yeah. So, man, I just want to, take this moment of time to talk to y'all about social media, man, and just how to move on that thing. Because there's a lot of people, that's trying to build their brand, that's trying to make it to the next level in life. And, you know, it's a lot of people out here just trying to be their own type of entrepreneurs. And, I've been online doing my own thing probably since 2008. Yeah, 2008. I've been in the game for 11 years. And, you know, there's always room for improvement. You know what I'm saying? You're never going to be 1,000% on top of things. But I figured since I'm already experienced, I can give y'all some tips on how to move on this thing. So I ain't never seen nobody touch on this type of topic. So let me go ahead and break it down to y'all. So on social media, man, I noticed that a lot of people out here, they do things to try to make it to the next level, to try to evolve. And the number one error I see people make is when they watch other people and they literally imitate what they're doing, and they base that off of what they got running. And it's nothing wrong with going on other people's platforms and studying and taking game and taking notes and applying it to your game. You know what I'm saying? That's almost equivalent to sports. If you see somebody hitting a straight jab or a right hook, you know, they may not do it as well as you, or you may not be able to do it as well as them. But the thing is, you can study where they're going wrong. You can study where they're going right. Same thing in, like, you know, football or whatever. I might run quicker routes than you and make better cuts. That's just what it is. So there's nothing wrong with analyzing someone's game and just improving it. Because truth be told, there's nothing new under the sun. Nothing new under the sun. Everybody out here trying to figure it out. Everybody out here trying to improve themselves. So if you're trying to improve yourself, the number one thing I would say is don't base someone else's success to yours. You know what I'm saying? Because that right there, that could really, dig a hole for you. And it could be a hole that you may not be able to get yourself out of. You know, there's a lot of people online that are doing crazy stuff to go viral, trying to get the quick money, trying to get the quick fame, trying to get the quick success. And then you wonder at the end why you're not happy, why things ain't moving right for you, because you tried to take the sprint approach. In this day and age, on the internet, a lot of people are sprinting and they're not worried about the marathon. You know what I'm saying? A marathon is a relay. You know what I'm saying? You pass the baton on, you get the knowledge, and you pretty much just take your time. It's almost like the turtle win the race. But when you just straight up sprinting to the success, yeah, the money might be quick because the world moves fast. This is the fast moving era that we're in. We're just in different times. So money is moving fast at a faster rate than any other time that we've been living in, all because of social media. And this is what y'all need to take notes on, man. Never base someone else's success to yours. You know what I'm saying? Because I can for sure tell you, when people are online, I'm about to lace y'all with some real game. When people are online, they are putting up the best version of themselves. All right? Listen again. When people are online, they are putting up the best version of themselves. So while you over there sitting there saying, damn, man, that person got a car, man, that person got a new whip, that person got a new house, that person sitting on all this stash and all this other stuff, look, the internet ain't nothing but manipulation. And a lot of people, as you know, and you heard this term before, they fake it till they make it. Sad to say, we live in a world where people, they want to see what you're doing. They want to actually see if there's evidence and proof that you're living this way, and then they'll literally try to copy it. And then while you're trying to build your brand, you're wondering why it's not working out for you, because you don't know what that person had to do behind the scenes, or you don't know what they're literally doing right now behind the scene to make it appear that way. A lot of these people online, they are fucking bacon, bro. You know what I'm saying? I'm just tell you like that. Most people on this thing ain't got the money that you think they got. They're literally putting out that image so they can sell it to you, so it can make them look a certain type of way, you know, to make them feel better about themselves. And that's something that they got to truly deal with at the end of the day. But what you need to work on, you need to work on just building your brand at a slow pace. There's nothing wrong with falling back, working on the in-house and doing, you know, working on the admin department. Because when you always too busy worried about being in the front of things, then you're gonna lose track of what's happening in the back of things. All right, remember, listen to what I just said. When you're too busy worried about being in the front of things, aka being the face, aka being the you know, the front gunner, if you're not taking care of your admin department, if you're not taking care of your inventory, if you're not reevaluating yourself, reevaluating your brand, reevaluating people around you, where you're going wrong and everything, then you're going to set yourself up for self-destruction. All right. Now, remember, I said people always show the best version of themselves. And there's nothing wrong with that. You know what I'm saying? Because that's what you want to do. But I will say this too. You can't go wrong by making mistakes. A lot of people out here, they are too afraid to make mistakes. And social media has created this type of perception where people are putting out the best version of themselves. And as soon as someone see a type of error in your game or a flaw in your game, that's when they start pulling your card and saying, aha, aha, I knew you couldn't do it, or I knew it wasn't like that. When in actuality, man, we all out here failing, you know? You can't be the best version of yourself without even failing. So you gotta be okay with making mistakes, all right? If you ain't bumping your head, you know what I'm saying, you ain't really doing nothing. You know, you gotta shoot 1,000 shots. You gotta shoot 1,000 shots and 1,000 threes just to perfect your game. And even when you shoot 1,000, you might not even be the best. A lot of people say Ben Simmons ain't got the best jump shot. You know, every time he fucking shoot, them bitches don't go in. Do you know how many shots Ben Simmons took in his life and he still can't get his game right now? Of course, he's probably getting his game tightened up now, but like I say, man, don't be afraid to make mistakes. Because honestly, there are real people out there in the world that will study your game and they will respect your game more if you show your mistakes. So it's okay to show your mistakes. It's okay to even talk about it. It's okay to even interact with your people and show them, hey, this is where I went wrong. You know what I'm saying? This is where I'm going wrong. And, you know, it's all about building, like I say, a marathon of people that's going to follow you and support you forever. If you're too busy putting out your perfection, then a lot of people can kind of get turned off by that, because they're like, look, man, I can't really even learn from this cat. He just looking like a perfect ass nigga. And this is why those people always get their card pulled. If you always try to appear like you're perfect, and you always try to appear that you just can't be touched and that you just out here just doing it, then eventually when you get your card pulled, everything gonna crumble down. Everything's gonna crumble down, man. So worry about yourself. Worry about building your own. All right. There's nothing wrong with studying. There's nothing wrong with looking and applying. But when you just straight up copying, straight up jacking, and just straight up just trying to imitate, you know, someone style, that ain't right. You know what I'm saying? It's not even right for you, not for them, because that person gonna be that person regardless. You gotta understand where you going wrong. You gotta understand who you are. And if you don't understand who you are and what type of brand you're building and what direction and what goals you got, you know, what goals you're trying to master, it's all gonna fall apart. All right. So brand building is very important. Take care of your baby like you take care of anything else that you value in life, whether it's your mom, whether it's your money or whatever, man. So, you know, it's not easy as well, man. You got to put in the faith. You got to put in the consistency, and you got to put in the hard work. You got to put in the faith. You got to put in the consistency, and you got to put in the hard work. It's going to be some sleepless nights. It's going to be some nights and some days when you be like, look, man, I want to fucking quit. But that's normal. You know what I'm saying? It's normal to feel discouraged sometimes. But it's not normal when you acting like everything is all good. And I understand a lot of people don't want people to see them sweat as well. Because, you know, in all actuality, man, people are, a lot of people aren't deserving of seeing that type of stuff, because you know all they're gonna do is judge. But this is why you don't focus on everybody, you know what I'm saying? You only focus on the people that's trying to be a part of your process, that respects your journey. If you focusing on the people who's just criticizing your work, or just, you know, trying to pull your card all the time, trying to find constant flaw in your game, don't even pay attention to them folks. You actually need to block them folks, or just block them out of your life, or just don't even look that way. You find out what works best for you. But only focus on the people that's showing you love, and that's showing love and putting that respect on your journey. Your journey tells the biggest story, because you can't tell a story and you can't be a teacher out here if you ain't going through nothing. You know what I'm saying? Or if you're not really going through a journey. There's no way how you're gonna just wake up and everything just working out, unless you just put out a video or something and it just pop overnight. But even then, when you just as fast as you get it, it's just as fast as you can lose it. All right, just as fast as you get it, it's just as fast you can lose it. So the slow burn is always, you know, the best way to earn most time. And you know, this is why you hear a lot of cats saying, man, I've been in this game for 10, 15, 20 years, man, I've been out here. And you probably 2 years in, you probably a couple months in, you already getting discouraged. Look, they've been through the same thing you've been through, man. I've been homeless for this shit, you know what I'm saying? I done slept out my car for this shit, man. Look, I done been through it all. I done slept house to house, couch to couch. And you know, those are the typical stories that people go through. Of course, you know, you go through your stuff. I done had all kind of negative balances and everything, man. Like, this shit ain't easy. But I've also had a lot of glory days as well, man. But the key is to keep the faith, the consistency, and the hard work. You got to keep the FCHW, man. If you don't have the FCHW, you don't have the faith, the consistency, or the hard work, and you don't apply those things to whatever method you got running, whatever type of you know, program you got running, then hey, you're gonna hit a brick wall and you're gonna drop. So always remember, man, keep your head up, you know what I'm saying, and keep your toes and keep your foot solid on the ground, you know what I'm saying? Don't fold under pressure. Pressure's gonna come, that's normal. Pressure, you know, life, what is life without pressure? What is life without challenges? You need those things to help build your character. But you only fail when you quit, all right? You only fail when you quit. So I just wanted to put that quick message out there for everybody, man. This is Unspoken Truth, you know, podcast, Unspoken Truth, YouTube channel. Make sure y'all subscribe, hit that notification bell, select all, go to my Spoken Reasons channel, and also too, go to SpokenReasonsTV.com, and you know, get the FCHW merchandise. I got a whole bunch of stuff on there, and you know, man, look, I just wanted to lace y'all with some stuff that I felt like somebody needed. You know, somebody out there needs this type of message and this type of game. So look, like I said, man, it's okay to watch others, it's okay to study, but make sure you figure out who you are, you know, because when you figure out who you are, then the people are going to follow. The people are going to follow regardless of which, the people are going to follow. And try not to make money the number one priority. You know what I'm saying? It's cool to get your bread. I'm not saying don't get your bread. But when you make money the number one focus, then a lot of times, people tend to lose sight of the true focus and the true goal of where they need to be. You may not even reach your true potential because you're too worried about the bag. And like I said before, all money ain't good money. So you got to be okay with turning things down for a potential bigger gain. So if someone offering you $1 million now, you got to understand and look at yourself like, damn, this person offered me $1 million. So if they're offering me $1 million, what can I make for myself? You know, I can probably get 5 off myself. The road might be harder to travel, you know, and people might judge you and say, damn, man, why you let that $1 million go? Why you let that bag go? I would have done that, man. Hey, all right, cool. You pick what's best for you. I'm not saying don't get the bag, but what I'm saying is always study and evaluate someone when they're giving you the bag. If someone says, hey, I got $100,000 for you, always look at it and say, you know what? If that person offered me $100,000, I know I can at least get 250. And understand this, the road is always going to look confusing to the people outside looking in. They're not going to understand the moves you're making. They're going to be like, man, what you doing? I don't understand what you're doing. And a lot of times people tend to hate. People tend to dislike you. People tend to try to put salt in your game, all in the name of misunderstanding. You know, I've dealt with that shit a lot of times. I'm still dealing with that. Man, when you gonna drop video? Well, how come your stuff ain't moving like this? Man, what you doing, man? What you should be doing? No, what you should be doing is shutting the fuck up and worrying about yourself. That's what you should be doing. And that's what I'm doing. Create your own universe. Create your own universe of people that's like-minded and hang out with like-minded individuals. Cool. You ain't got like-minded individuals around you that's on the same path that you on, or that have the same type of mentality, at least a 80%, you know, 80% to what's really going on, then hey man, your brand is gonna end up crumbling, man. So you gotta have the right spirits, you gotta have the right energy, you gotta have the right mindset of people that's on the same page as you. Because when you don't have that, it's gonna be hard to build your universe. And also understand too, man, evaluate everybody that's around you, just like I said before, because you never know who's, you know, like I say, man, the people who can cut you the most are the people that's the closest. So, you know, everybody ain't got to be a part of your brand. Everybody ain't got to be a part of what you got going just because they're your mom, just because they're your dad. Of course, you want to build your empowerment within your circle, but not everybody is going to make it over to the next level. So you got to be okay with cutting people off, even if it's like a family member or something like that. You know, not everybody's qualified, and that's what it is. When you go on a job and they scan your resume and they see what's going on, you may not be totally qualified for that position. And don't take it personal as well. So if you're working for someone and you know, you're a brother or a cousin or a best friend, and that person decides to reevaluate you and say, hey man, I'm gonna have to move on to bigger and better things or whatever, or just I'm gonna have to move on to, you know, different routes, don't take that personal, man. You know, just move on and just look at it like it's business. But you know, in this day and age, especially in this day and age, people are so fucking sensitive, they don't understand that. And that's when motherfuckers want to get in their feelings and start dissing you on Twitter and Instagram and all the other stuff, all because they just don't understand and they got their panties in a bunch. And as a boss, because you're a boss no matter how much money you got, remember, it's your universe. You're a boss regardless. Always look at your thing like you are building a universe. This is my entity, you know what I'm saying? This is my baby that I built. I've been working on this thing 24/7. You ain't been here. You ain't been with me shooting in the gym, bruh. That's just what it is. So you're gonna have to make sacrifices. And sacrifices ain't nothing but decisions, you know what I'm saying? It ain't nothing but decisions that you don't want to make, but you're going to have to make it, because it's like a make or break, a make or break. If I don't do this, this could happen. If I don't do this, this could happen. But sacrifices are going to hurt. It ain't a sacrifice if it don't hurt. Sacrifices are painful, you know what I'm saying? It's painful as hell, and they're very hard to overcome sometimes. But once you understand that and you gain the knowledge and you evolve and you grow throughout the months, throughout the days, throughout the weeks, throughout the years, then you'll start to see everything unfold. But you only fail when you quit, all right? So yeah, pay attention to yourself, learn yourself, you know, take care of your body, make sure you're eating the right food, you know what I'm saying? Because a lot of times the food that we put in our body can alter our thinking process. So make sure you're putting all the right food in your body, get your exercise in, get your sleep in, and just be a good person, man. Put out the good energy, because when you're putting out fucked up energy, that same energy gonna come back. So smile through the bullshit, even when the bullshit doesn't seem like it's going nowhere. Smile through the bullshit, don't let nobody see you sweat, all right? So it's your boy JB, aka Spoken. Like I said, hit subscribe, hit the like button, pass this video on, and I'm out.